Muslim leaders and clergy have agreed to embark on a religious campaign countrywide to counter the narrative of clerics who are radicalizing youth. Political leaders also weighed in on the way forward after such a tragedy. Patrick Amimo has the details.
Days after Al-Shabaab militants massacred students at Garissa University College, Muslim leaders attending an international Islamic conference in Nairobi met and condemned the killings. They say continued attacks by Al-Shabaab under the guise of Islam must be resisted by all Muslims.
We are calling upon all Muslims, whether you are a leader, whether you are an imam or an ordinary Muslim in this country, you have a responsibility. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will ask you on the day of Qiyamah, we cannot keep quiet in the face of evil.
This is not and has nothing to do with our religion. We don't expect them to speak for us. We don't want them to act for us. They're just criminals who should actually be apprehended and prosecuted.
A section of Muslim clerics have been spreading jihadism through radical preachings. Leaders here agreed radicalization was real, but promised to counter the narrative of clerics keen to radicalize youths and cause sectarian conflict in Kenya.
This is an issue beyond our control, beyond the control of any globally positioned nations. As Kenyans and as Muslims, we are trying to do everything possible, as much as our Christian brothers are trying to handle extremism from the evangelists and the Pentecostals,
who make sure the perpetrators, all of them, not only the foot soldiers, because we know mostly it is the foot soldiers who are arrested, even the planners or even those who hold this kind of ideologies, we want to appeal to our law enforcement agencies and our security agencies to follow the law and make sure that the full force of the law is affected.
Former President Daniel Arap Moi has condemned the Garissa killings. While condoling with the bereaved and wishing quick recovery to survivors of the attack, Moi urged the government to guarantee security for all Kenyans and stop senseless killings.
I think security throughout the country should be taken seriously. And also unity is required everywhere for all Kenyans to face the future courageously.
NARC Kenya leader Martha Karua urged the government to work closely with the international community in sharing security intelligence on the war on terror. She wants residents in northern Kenya to exercise patriotism and smoke out suspected criminals in their localities.
Do not agree to let terrorists isolate your areas and make them no-go zones for the rest of Kenyans.
Speaking from Kwale during the burial of Sister Tukod co-principal Kalonzo Musyoka, CORD leaders reiterated their call for national dialogue to find practical solutions to insecurity.
Hata ukiajiri askari 1,100, hiyo sio suluhisho. Kuna suluhisho ambayo mpaka ifanyika. Kama tujafanya mna hiyo, utafanya yote yale yote itakuwa ni bure. Mpaka tuketi chini tutafute suluhisho.
We must decide to act decisively. Lazima tunusuru nchi yetu. Hakuna wengine watatusaidia kuinusuru vile mimi naamini wa Somali peke yao ndio watanusuru inchi yao ya Somalia.
And speaking from Yala in Siaya County during the burial of former game member of parliament Grace Ogot, the wife of renowned academician Professor Bethel Ogot, Siaya Senator James Orengo led other politicians in urging the government to revise its military strategy in dealing with Al-Shabaab.
You cannot justify being in Somalia when people are dying in Kenya. The intention of us to Somalia is to degrade the Al-Shabaab in Somalia so that they do not have the capacity to come to Kenya. As we speak today, Somalia is Africa's Afghanistan. And every country which goes into Somalia must also go in with a strategy and go in with an exit strategy. But we want to tell the government, do the right thing. Let us sort out the security mess once and for all.
Meanwhile, a section of residents in Eastleigh, under the banner of Eastleigh Residents and Business Community Association, held a peaceful demonstration to condemn the Garissa killings. Patrick Amimo, KTN.